What's up, everyone? Today I want to talk to you about MAXTRAX and if they actually work and if they're worth it. So let's dive in. So these MAXTRAX have been on this rig for like 5 years. And as you can see, they are pretty worn. Now, this is from improper use. They say right here, no wheel spin. So with MAXTRAX, the idea is you get buried, you dig up a little bit, you wedge the track really nice into the tire, and you just let the vehicle idle out. With a 10,000 pound truck stuck in the sand, easier said than done. Sometimes you just goose it a little too much. And well, you rip all your knobs apart. So that's why the new MAXTRAX are pretty cool with the metal little tips on there. Really wanna try some of those out. I've heard you could drill these out and just like put screws in there, which I could, that would make it, you know, have some grip again. But this side's still good, so we'll just use that. Biggest scenario where I'd say I get stuck and I jump out and the first thing I go to is my MAXTRAX is in the sand. In the sand, you can easily use the MAXTRAX as a shovel. So you grab it, you start shoveling out, you stick it in there. It's a lot easier to use in the sand. I've never had to use them in the snow. Mud, and even sand and snow and everything. Anytime you use these, the biggest thing you wanna think about beforehand is burying the MAXTRAX. So I got stuck in the sand once and I used my MAXTRAX and it took me about a half an hour to find the MAXTRAX because it was buried in the sand. So a good idea is to have like a leash on it, some sort of tie down or rope or just anything that's at least maybe 10 or 15 feet long to where you can pull, and if you have to, you can even winch your MAXTRAX out of the ground. All right, we got this far. This MAXTRAX is stuck. I just had to dig like 3 or 4 holes to even find it. It's so silly. That is, I think, my biggest tip for this video. If you haven't used MAXTRAX and you're getting them, and you're going into some deep stuff where it might get pushed. I mean, think about it. You're rolling over it, and as you roll over it, just your whole rig just pushes that thing under. So put some leashes on, experiment with that. It'll save you some time and potentially save your MAXTRAX. So I want to show you also how I have these things locked up and how I keep them secure. Because anyone that sees these goes, oh, $300. So this right here, so this is what we call a hip lock. So this is a steel reinforced zip tie. And as you can see, it's threaded through the post here so you can't get the MAXTRAX off. So these have been really awesome. These are $20 for 2 on Amazon. I'll link these below. I also use these to lock on shovels, axes, the rotopacks are already locked. Anything, they're really great for locking stuff on the outside of your rig. And honestly,
I also just saw X Overland using MAXTRAX as cleats. They flipped them over and they were winching out another rig with their Gladiator and they drove the Gladiator on them to actually hold it in place. So that was really cool. Those guys have a lot of very unique ways that they use MAXTRAX to get over bridges or create, you know, a trail. The more you have, the merrier. And I have 2 on this rig and I definitely would like 4. And if everyone you're with has 4, then that's a pretty cool scenario that you can get out of. Now, we all have winches too. I think it's still so important to have a winch. I don't think having MAXTRAX means you don't need a winch at all. But to me, a winch is a last resort. It's a lot of force. It's deadly force. If used improperly, it can kill you. And that's scary stuff. A MAXTRAX, not so much, you know? I guess a MAXTRAX could spit out from a tire and, you know, do some damage. But I've never heard of that. Anyways, it's a lot safer. I think we can all agree MAXTRAX are a lot safer. Anything is a lot safer than winching right away. It's very important to be aired down, though, with the MAXTRAX. That should be a given. You should already be aired down if you're getting stuck. But I'll be honest, I've used them aired up before in a panic, just trying to get up when I didn't think I was going to get stuck somewhere. And it's real easy to roast those knobs off when you're doing that. So don't do that. Should you buy knockoff MAXTRAX? I don't know. I mean, I've seen them. They work. I don't know about the mounting options. MAXTRAX have really good mounting options, which I like a lot. And also, like I said, with the new MAXTRAX having the metal tips on them, I don't know, man. I think those are the best. I've seen some other aftermarket tracks snap and fail. Never in person. So I don't know, it's hard to say. Yoderholm uses some knockoffs on his. You just think about when you need it, are you gonna want a knockoff or are you gonna want the real thing? I mean, it's as simple as it is to me. Well, I hope this video helped you decide about MAXTRAX or give you some thoughts and opinions on them. Thanks so much for watching. Be sure to comment below, do you use MAXTRAX? What are your opinions on MAXTRAX? Do you use the off brands? I'm curious what you guys are using out there. Hit that like if you did enjoy it. Make sure that you're subscribed to the channel because I got a lot of cool stuff coming up here in 2020. The question is, are you down to mob?